The Fat Man Bomb was much more complicated than Little Boy. Author Richard Rhodes explains why Manhattan Project scientists couldn't use plutonium for the gun-type bomb and how the implosion method worked.
There was a crucial point in the program at Los Alamos in the summer of 1944 when it was realized that plutonium, of which you needed a lot less than highly enriched uranium to make a bomb, was so fissile that if you tried to use the standard design that was going to be used for the uranium bomb, which was basically a 3-inch Navy cannon about 6 feet long with one piece of uranium attached to the muzzle and another piece as a sort of bullet fired up the barrel to mate with the other piece to make a critical mass and start the bomb going, that if you tried to do that with plutonium, they discovered that summer, this piece would melt down before it even got up to the other end of the barrel, even if it were fired at 3,000 feet per second. That's how reactive plutonium was. And then they realized that they were going to have to invent an entirely new technology, one that would involve taking a solid ball of plutonium that was just subcritical, squeeze it with high explosives to almost double its normal density, thereby pushing the atoms of plutonium closer together and making the chain reaction possible, making, if you will, the critical mass much smaller because it's denser.